Welcome to the course on all about Control A to Control Z shortcuts in Excel. Shortcuts enable you to complete an operation or a task quickly in one or two keystrokes instead of going through the menu. In this lesson, we will learn about the Windows keyboard shortcut Control for Excel. Control A to Control Z. Please note that these shortcuts will not work on Mac. I have grouped these shortcuts logically instead of alphabetically to understand and remember them better.
Use this channel to upskill your expertise on Microsoft Excel, Word or PowerPoint. Do subscribe if not done already.
Let us start with the Control A. Depending upon where your mouse cursor is, this shortcut is used to select the worksheet or the data area. So if your cursor is here, if I press Control A now, this selects the entire worksheet. But if you have your cell selected here inside the data area, then if you press Ctrl A, this selects only the data area. Let me demonstrate again. If you are in a worksheet outside the data area, it selects the entire worksheet. But if you are within the data area, it selects only the data area, not the entire worksheet. Let's see the next shortcut. If you press Ctrl B, this makes the text bold. If you see here in the Home tab, in font, the letter B is selected there. So if you press Ctrl B again, then the bold will go away. And if you want to make a text in italics, select the text and then press Ctrl I. Then Ctrl U is for underlining the text. As in any other case, if you press Ctrl U again, then the underlining will go away. The next set of shortcuts are Ctrl C, Ctrl X and Ctrl V. So you know that when you want to copy, you can copy by pressing Ctrl C. That you can see here, a dotted line all around the area that has been copied. If you go to the clipboard under Home tab in the ribbon and then press on this arrow, then you know that what has been copied to the clipboard. All the text have been copied into the clipboard. Now, if you want to paste this, you just need to press Ctrl V. If you want to cut a text, select the text, press Ctrl X. If you want to paste that in a different area, press Ctrl V. This is all about Ctrl C, Ctrl X and Ctrl V. If you have a cell content that you want to copy downward in this same column, select the cell as well as the remaining cells, then press Ctrl D. This will fill up all the cells down in the column. If you want to fill that to the right of the cells, then select the cells and then press Ctrl R. The 10th shortcut is Ctrl E. This is known as flash fill. We have covered flash fill in one of the earlier lessons. Suppose you have a table like this. You have first name, last name, and then you want to create a short name as well as combining the first name and the last name. So short name will be something like Fred. And then if you move down and then press Ctrl E, then this will copy the remaining cells with the same pattern as in the above cell. This is called flash fill. You can also combine first name and last name using this Frederick Johnson, and then if you press Ctrl E here, this will fill up combining the first name and last name. This is normally what you will do is you will type this and then you will go to the fill in Home tab and then there is a flash fill option there, or you can also do that from data tab. Here you have the flash fill option. Instead of that, you can use the Ctrl E shortcut. Sometimes you have a large amount of data where you want to find some values, so you will use Ctrl F. This will open up the find and replace dialog box. So I want to find USA. Then if you click find next, this will go to the text where it is there. Then if you click again find next, it will go to the next instance. Instead of that, if you click find all, then this will bring up all the instances where this particular text is appearing in a cell. And Ctrl H is for replacing. Sometimes you may want to replace a particular value with something else. Say for example, I want to replace this USA with United States. So you can find and then you can replace, or you can also use this key replace all. Then this will replace all the instances. So Control F is for find a text or a value, and Control H is to replace. You can do this from the Home tab, and then under Editing, you have the Find and Replace options here. Control G is called Go To. So if you press Control G, then there is a dialog box which comes here, and if you give a reference here, cell reference, say for example I have D4, then if you click OK, my cursor will go to the D4 cell. So Control G is for go to. I can give any reference, say for example I give G19. When you press OK, this will take you to the cell which has been input in the reference. This will go to G19. You can also use the menu here under Editing, Find and Select, you have go to. Control K is for inserting a hyperlink. Sometimes you may want to refer to other sheets, or you may want to refer to a website, whatever. Select the cell where you want the hyperlink appearing, and then press Control K. So the insert hyperlink will appear. You can link to the existing page or a place in the document. A place in the document is a cell reference, or a new document, or email address, whatever. So if I select this and then click OK, then the link has already been created. So if you go and click on that, this will take me to the hyperlink tab. That's 8 and 9. You can also provide an external web address like www.yahoo.com. This will take you to the website, the address of which is given here. So Control L is to create a table. And Control T is also for creating a table. So if you have a data like this, select any of the cell inside the range and then click Control L. The Create Table dialog box will come up. If you want the headers, you select this checkbox and then click OK. The data range will be converted into a table. You can also use Control T and then create the table for the cell range. If you see here, under the Design tab in Table Tools, the table name has been given as Table 2. You can give a name here. If you do not want this range to be a table, again you can convert that to a range. This will be a normal range. Now you don't see the Table Tools tab here was appearing when you convert this into a table. Again, I convert this into a table, the Table Tools will appear. So Control N is used to create a new workbook. You can create a new workbook by going to this new in your quick toolbar, or you can go and then create new here in your file menu. Instead of that, if you give Control N, this will create a new workbook. And Control O is to open an existing workbook. So I give Control O. This will take me to this open dialog where you have the workbooks which are listed here, or you can go to the folders and then you can click open any of the workbook you want. Control S to save. If you click Control S, this will save in the background. I give Control S. You don't see whether it has saved or not. Let me take the other worksheet which I just created. So if I click Control S here, then you will get a dialog where you want to save this file. Then Control W is to close the workbook. So let me open another workbook here, Control N, and then if I give Control W, that workbook will be closed. So if I close this workbook, Control W, then this will ask for saving the changes before closing it. So let me cancel that. So Control N is for new workbook, Control O is for open an existing workbook, Control S is to save the workbook, and Control W is to close the workbook. Then Control P is for print. So if you press Control P, then the print dialog box will appear. You have a print preview here, and you have a printer option and other settings here. Before seeing Control Y, let's see Control Z. So Control Z to undo. Say for example, I select this and then I delete this data. And if I press Control Z, this will undo. So you see all the data here. But if you do Control Y here, then this will redo. That is deleting that. So Control SZ is for undo, Control Y is for redo. So this is all about the control shortcuts. We have seen all the shortcuts from Control A to Control Z. Hope you will be using these shortcuts to do the tasks quickly in Excel.
If you have not subscribed to this channel yet, please do subscribe. If you want to leave a comment, please do that.